Hello, my name is Danny Nolan and I'm the Director of Chassissim Technologies. And welcome to this latest episode of Dan's Vehicle Dynamics Corner combined with a Chassissim tutorial. Today, ladies and gentlemen, I want to talk to you about a little known feature of simulation in Chassissim, but it's actually very, very exciting. What we're going to be talking to you about today is using advanced simulation channels. And to kick off this discussion, when we take a look at simulated data, most people, when they're looking at simulated data, they'll primarily focus on, particularly if they're using lap time simulation, they'll primarily focus in on lap time. And then they'll move to driver channels like steer, throttle, brake, and RPM, just to see what the driver was doing. And occasionally you do get some people who will then move to the more advanced channels like dampers, maybe have the occasional look at yaw rate, but that's pretty much where the bulk of simulation users will stop looking at their data. But here's the thing, ladies and gentlemen, Chassissim in particular comes now with over 150 plus logged channels. And the great thing about this can be used for a multitude of purposes. And in particular, for this tutorial, I'd like to give a big shout out to Chassissim customer Supershock Dampers, who actually suggested this tutorial in the first place. So a big shout out to Oscar Fiorinotto and the crew at Supershock. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, deducing load cases for suspensions. One of Chassissim's return channels is the forces at the contact patch. So what we've got here is we've got a simulation for an F3 car. So we've got speed, we've got RPM, we've got steered angle, neutral steer, throttle. Now, in here is the money shot. We've got the lateral forces at the contact patch. So we've got our front left and front right lateral contact patch forces and our rear left and rear right lateral contact patch forces at the rear. Now, the great thing about this, ladies and gentlemen, is this gives you not just the maximum points for doing a static analysis. What you've got here is that you've got a full spectra for you to be able to do things like fatigue loading, etc., etc., because now you've got all of this through the lap. All you've got to do is plug this into your FEA, into your finite element analysis package, or put it on a rig, and then you can start to see what this is actually doing. Now, Chassissim just returns the contact patch forces. So, what's a quick and dirty way that we can get to the actual loads at the wishbones? Well, if we take a look at a typical free body diagram of your hub, you've got your contact patch force there, and you've got your lower wishbone force, F21, and your upper wishbone force, F34. So if you go through and you do the force analysis, you'll find out that your upper force is about half the contact patch and your lower force is 1.5 times the contact patch. Now that's going to vary depending on your geometry, but that's a really quick and dirty way, ladies and gentlemen, that if you've got these lateral contact patches throughout the lap, you can then resolve these at the individual wishbone loads. So this way that you can use your simulator data to start doing some pretty hard numbers in terms of what structurally to expect from the car. Another great thing that Chassissim returns is it actually returns the absolute force at the wheel at the spring damper unit. Now, so what we've got here is we've got exactly the same lap. So we've got speed, RPM, steered angle, neutral steer, throttle, but this time in here, we've got the spring force on the front and the rear right spring damper unit, and that includes the spring force and the damper force, and we've got the same thing at the rear. So here we've got front left, front right, here we've got rear left, rear right, and it also returns the force applied at the roll bar. So the great thing is that if you're designing a car or you've got some questions in terms of doing some due diligence on the race car that you have, again, you can take these forces and plug them in to your FEA package or load it on a KNC rig so that you get the full gambit of what's actually going on. So that's another really powerful application of this. Differential tuning. Now, I've talked about this at length both in my tutorials on front wheel, how to tune a front wheel drive car and how to do differential tuning. They're actually some of the most watched tutorials on the Chassissim YouTube page. Now, the great thing about differential tuning is that in addition to returning the longitudinal force of the contact patch, Chassissim also returns the maximum possible forces that you can longitudinally that you can get from the contact patch. So what you can do is that you can use this to tune the differential characteristics that you want. And the other thing too, and I've been a little bit remiss here, is that Chassissim returns the individual wheel speeds, so you can make a math channel to see what the differential wheel speeds are. So that all of a sudden is going to guide you in to how to tune your differential using simulated data. Because the harsh reality is, ladies and gentlemen, is once that differential is in the car, actually having to rip the differential out is a very, very large job. So with this, you can really tune this and make sure that you pretty much are in the ballpark, so you can pretty much, the differential becomes fire and forget. Now, I spoke more about how to do this both in the front wheel drive tuning tutorial and the differential force tutorial, so I might just leave that for you to cross-reference with that. And the last case study that I want to discuss, ladies and gentlemen, is determining control power. Now, the great thing about Chassissim is it returns yaw rate, and it also returns steered angle at the tire. So what that is, if you plot steered angle versus yaw rate and you curve fit this, this gives you the control power. So if you start making setup adjustments and you really want to see what it's going to do, all you've got to do is either overlay these plots or overlay the curve fits. And then you've got a very, very powerful insight to go, oh, hang on, this is what the car's going to do on the initial steer application, but this is what it's going to be like once we actually apply quite a bit of steering lock. So that, again, gives you a lot of different tuning options. Now, to sum up, the great thing about all of the advanced simulation and channel, the advanced simulation channels in Chassissim, is they go well beyond just looking at lap times. In addition to the basics, you can dive in with incredible detail. But the thing about it is, ladies and gentlemen, what we've discussed here is this just scratches the surface. One of the great things, and let me sort of give you a couple of case studies about this. One of the great things about Chassissim is that within the Chassissim community, I will have people come up to me and say, well, hang on, what do you think about this? And I'll go, oh, that's a good idea. And for example, some of the toolboxes like the track replay toolbox, the Chassissim shaker rig toolbox, actually weren't driven by me. They were driven by Chassissim customers. So given that you've now got over 150 plus used channels to play with, and you can draw out details like this, and draw out details like this, go off and have some fun. If you're already an existing Chassissim user, play with this. If you are a potential Chassissim user, sign up to our online simulation and play with this. And we will catch you in the next Dan's Vehicle Dynamics Corner / Chassissim tutorial.